Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our science session. So in today's science session, I have bring you new lesson and the name of that lesson is what? Getting to know plants. Okay, so obviously in this lesson you are going to see the deeply study, or we are going to do the deeply study about the plants. Okay, so let's start the lesson. As we are going to see in our surrounding, there are the number of the plants are present on the earth or in our surrounding. Okay, but among that all the plants, each and every plant is different from another. Okay, if you see the any plant, means some are having the red color flower, some are having the violet color flower, purple, yellow, pink, like that. Their leaf structure is also different, their leaf shape is also different. Okay, so in this way, this some are the very tall, some are short, some are crawling on the ground. Okay, so in this way there are the variety of the plants are present in our surrounding, in our nature. Okay, so according to the or on the basis of size and nature of stem, most of the plants are classified into three categories. Okay, on the basis of which probably? On the basis of size, nature of stem, and these are the two basic criteria that we have used to classify the plants into three categories, and the three categories are herbs, shrubs and trees. Okay, these are the three categories that we can see, or in this three category we have classified the plants. Okay, on the basis of their size and the nature of the stems, the plants are classified into three categories, that are herbs, shrubs and trees. Okay, so these each categories are having certain types of the characteristics. So let's discuss their characteristics with the help of these certain parameters. Okay, so we'll discuss about the first parameter, that is what? Height. Okay, so we'll discuss about the height of all these three categories. First we will discuss about the herbs. So what is the height of the herbs? The height, herbs are generally having the short height. Okay, so the herbs are having generally the short height, while the shrubs are having the medium size height. Okay, what about the shrubs? The shrubs are having the medium size height, while the trees are having the very tall, or the trees are very tall, they are having the more height, they are very tall. This is about the height. Now we are going to the next characteristics or the next parameter, that is what? Color of the stem. So if we talk about the herbs, then the color of the herbs or the stem of the herbs are green in color, while the stem of the shrubs are brown in color, and the stem of the trees are also brown in color. Next one, we discuss about the thickness of the stem. Okay, thickness of the stem. So if we talk about the herbs, then the herbs are having the thin stem, while the shrubs are having the not very thick stem. Okay, not very thin also, not very thick also. So the not very thick stems are present in the shrubs, while in the trees the stem is very thick, which we are calling as what? Tree trunk. Okay, so in the trees the stems are very thick, which is we are calling as what? And very hard also. Okay, so in this way the stems are very thick in the trees. Next one we will discuss, that is hardness of the stem. So what about the hardness of the herbs? Herbs are not hard. Okay, they are very soft. If we talk about the shrubs, then shrub stems are hard. And the third one is what? Trees. If we talk about the trees, then the trees are having very thick stem. Okay, or very hard stem. Okay, so up till now we have discussed the four criteria. We have discussed about the height, color of the stem, thickness of the stem, and now also we have discussed about the hardness of the stem. So hardness of the stem, herbs are soft, shrubs are hard, and the trees are very hard. Okay, the stem of the trees are very hard. Now we move for the next one, that is what? Branching pattern. Okay, means how exactly the branches are present in the herbs, shrubs and trees. Okay, so let's see in the branching pattern. Okay, if we talk about the herbs, then the basically these herbs are having, basically these herbs may not have the more branches. Okay, the herbs may not have the many branches. Why? If we will talk about the shrubs, okay, if we will talk about the shrubs, then the shrubs are having the branches which are near to the ground. Suppose this is one plant, these are the roots in the soil. So from here the branches grows. The shrubs are having the many branches which grows from the ground, or which is very near to the ground, we can say. Okay, the branches are very close to the ground in shrubs, and in the herbs they may not have the many branches. Next one category, that is what, trees. If we talk about the trees, the branching pattern of the trees, then trees are having the many more branches which are quite above from the ground. Okay, so here I will draw one picture. So as we know, this is the plant and these roots or these branches are very above from the ground. There is a more distance between the branches and the ground. The branches are above from the ground. There is a more distance between the branches and the ground. Okay. Now we'll move for the next parameter, that is lifespan. Okay, that is lifespan. So lifespan means what? How much times the plants will grow? That is what, from the birth to the death. That span is called as what? Lifespan. So like that human being is having lifespan, like that the plants are also having the lifespan, because the plants are also a living things. So what about the lifespan of the herbs? Herbs are having the lifespan, they can live for the 1 to 2 seasons. Okay. Next one about the shrubs. The shrubs are having, or the shrubs can grow, can survive for the several years, but less than trees. And next one, that is what, trees. The trees can grow for many more years. Okay. Trees can live for the several years. Okay. So this is about the lifespan. And now we'll discuss the examples. If we'll talk about the examples of the herbs, there's so many herbs we are using in our house also. We are using the leafy vegetables. That leafy vegetables are nothing but what? All herbs. We can say the spinach is there, fenugreek is there, okay? Our coriander is there, all mint is there. All these are what? Examples of the herbs. We'll talk about the shrubs. Then lemon is there. Also we can say hibiscus is there. All these are the examples of the shrubs. In the herbs, we can add so many more examples. We can add the mustard, sunflower, tomato. All these are the examples of what? Herbs. And now about the trees. So the trees are having so many examples. We can see the mango tree, jackfruit tree, cashew nut trees. All these neem tree is there, banyan is there, peepal is there. All these are the trees which comes in the category. Or these are the plants that comes in the tree category. Okay. So like there's so many plants are there, and all these plants are get divided or they get classified into these three major categories. Okay. So now one activity is there on the page number 56. That activity you have to do. You have to visit in your garden near to your house, or surrounding your house are also having so many plants. You have to observe that plant and you have to categorize that plant into the herbs, shrubs and trees. And you have to write with their name of the plant, their height. Also, you have to write the further information which is given in the table. Okay. So, these are the certain categories and there are all the parameters now we have discussed. But along with these three categories, there are the certain plants which crawl on the ground or which runs on the ground. And that type of the plants are called as what? Creepers. That plants are called as what? Creepers. Now creepers means what? They are crawling on the ground and their stem is very weak. Okay. So that type of the plants are called as creepers. Okay. For example, we can say the bottle gourd is there, watermelon is there. All these are the plants there. Plants are crawling or they're running on the ground and they are called as what? Creeper. After that, there is one more category we can say, that there are the certain plants, their stem is weak, so it cannot stand straight. For to stand straight, they are taking the support of the other plant or other thing, and that type of the plants are called as what? Climbers. They are called as what? Climbers. From the name only we can understand. Climber. Climber means for something who is climbing on anything. Okay, so like that, there are the plants, their stem is weak, so they are taking the support of something and they are climbing over it, and they are called as what? Climbers. Okay, so these are the thing, these are the certain categories in that the plants are classified. If we talk about the examples of the climbers, then we can say the pea plant is there and the money plant is there. These are the some examples of the climbers. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about these different categories of the plants and their parameters also we have discussed. So in the image I will show you the different examples of the herbs. So see, these are the certain examples of the herb. Now we will see the different examples of the shrubs. Okay, so these are the certain examples of the shrubs are there. You can see the lemon is there, orange is there, China rose is also there. China rose, that only we are calling as what? Hibiscus. And now the next category, that is what? Trees. There are the so many examples of the tree. Banyan is there. Also we can have people is there. Okay, cashew nut, jackfruit. So many trees are there that we can see. But along with all these trees, I want to tell you that, have you seen the banana tree? Okay, if you have seen or if you have not seen, then see the image. Okay, how is the image? And observe the properly stem of the banana tree. How is it? Yes, correct. Is it? It is a green in color. Okay, so is it a tree? No, banana is not tree. Why? Because the stem is green, and that is the reason the banana is a herb. Okay, why? Because the herbs are having green color stem, and that is the reason the herbs or that banana comes in the herb category. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.